Teaquilts, and I'm here to show you the decals that I make. I had a couple of people on Facebook and YouTube ask me what decals do I sell, so I am going to show you those. Also, keep in mind that most of the decals that you see I also make on t-shirts, so if you want this in a shirt and or if you want it so you can put it on some hard surface, just let me know. So what I did for a vending event that I just came up with, I actually put all of my decals on these plastic sign stands, and I just used those because I felt it was a quick way for people to see what decals I offered instead of them having to go through each decal. And then also, some decals are hard to see because they have a white background, and whereas some of them have a different color background, and most of the decals are white, so it's hard to see white on white. So up first, I have the Love Your State Quilter, and I have them in all states they can be made, and they are $7 each. So I have shown here Missouri Quilter, and then when I turn this way, it has I'm an Illinois Quilter. But again, these can be made for any state at $7 a decal. Next up is the I Love to Quilt, and this I love to quilt because of the patchwork heart is $7. And then I also have one on here that does not have the patchwork heart, and it is $5. The next one here is one that I put on my husband's gas tank. His car is always on E every time I get in his car. So I made this man gas tank decal. It's $3. And then in addition to that, I made one with another figure that could be a female or any male that wears a ponytail. And it's also $3. And I do currently have this in black as well, so if you have a white or gray car, you may want to use that color of a decal. Right here you see my name. It's a decal that you can use to put on your sewing machines, and I'll try to remember to take a photo of my sewing machine with this decal on it so you can see what I mean. But a lot of the quilters that I make these for, they actually use this on their equipment that they bring to quilt retreat. So it could be on their sewing machines, it could be on their, some people travel with their metal rolling carts, it could be on your totes, your containers, your hard containers, not anything soft. It has to be a hard surface for it to work. But they use this to label a lot of stuff that they have, their art lights, their laptop computers, anything like that. They use these name tags. Get one name tag for $2.50. And for $22, what I offer is a sheet that will have 10 to 12 of your names. And I just did some names here so you can see how some of them will show up. They're approximately 1.5. They could be a little bit bigger, but 1.5 by 3. That's the minimum size I try to make your name. So just keep that in mind. And if you've got a longer name or a name that needs a fancy S, this area might be a little bit over 2.5 inches. But I try to make it so that you can read them. And again, the decals here, are the prices of the decals. They're $2.50 for one, or $22 for 10 to 12. And the reason why I say 10 to 12, because you'll get a, this is a big sheet, but you'll get a sheet like this with your decals, 10 to 12. And I just give myself 10 to 12 in case I mess two of them up. So I've made room for some error on my behalf. But my goal is to try to get everyone 12 if I don't have any issues with the weeding. So the last stand that I have here, I've already shown you the I Love to Quilt one. This one here says I stop for quilt shops and it is $6. Making sure it's $6. And then my price tag fell off. No, it didn't. This is also $6 and it's a two-tone decal. You can get this decal in pink or blue. It just says quilt maker. And then the last one that's on my boards is $6. This one here, fabric acquisition team, and that is $6. And I know that you're having some difficulty with glare, so I'm hoping that you can see these. Well, let me first say that everything that I've just shown you right now, you can actually get also on a t-shirt as well. Most of my t-shirts are $15 to $20 for sizes up to XL. You would add $5 for a 2XL plus. You would also add $3 if you want it in a ladies' V-neck. You would add $5 if you want it in a long sleeve. So that's currently the prices of my shirts as well. I also have license tag frames. And this one is Wild and Crazy Quilteron Board. And then this other one that I have is Going to Pieces. I'd Rather Be Quilting. And those are $7 each. And of course, anything that's out of the St. Louis area, I would also have to add the shipping on that as well. And in order for me to do your shipping, I would need to have your city, state, and zip. And then and your email. So you'll have to email me at teaquilts@teaquilts.com so that I can get your information, get whatever your order is packaged, and then I can also put that into an envelope so I can weigh it with your city, state, and zip. And then I will also send all of that information into PayPal and send you an invoice. And in addition to that, because I've had some people on my YouTube last night ordering the light kits that I have for my sewing machine. If you don't know what I'm talking about, go back and look at the live chat from last night. Anybody whose order is $25 or more, I will just throw in a Teaquilts button. I actually did this for the vending at the quilt show. So, yes, I will go ahead and extend that for this order process up to, I'll say, the end of October. And yeah, you'll get a free button. They're normally $3 for a button if you just want the button only. Then the button comes packaged in this little blue baggie here so that it doesn't get scratched with your other items in your order. So now what I'm gonna do also is take you outside and show you how to install a decal. I'm actually going to take the I Love to Quilt decal and put it on my car. I am outside at my car and I'm going to show you how to install the decal. So let me first tell you what you're going to need. Of course, you're going to need to have a decal. And then in addition to that, you're going to need a squeegee or a credit card. So if you have an old credit card or a hotel room key card, you can use that as well. Just something so that you can squeegee the decal on your car. I'm also going to be using rubbing alcohol to clean my car window. You do not want to let this get on your vehicle. Another thing that you can use to clean would be hand sanitizer will also work, as well as like any of your disinfectant wipes. You can use those as well. You just want something with some alcohol in it that's going to clean the surface. I'm going to be using a paper towel to install the alcohol, to add the alcohol and clean, and then I'm going to use a coffee filter so that I can get any remaining lint from the paper towel off the vehicle before I install. So that's it for what you need for installation. Let me zoom you in to a point on my window so you can see where I'm going to install it, as well as I'm kind of under a tree outside and the sun's facing the wrong direction, so I'm hoping that you can see what it is that I'm going to do. So one of the first things you want to determine is where you want to install your decal. You definitely don't want to install your decal around your
wiper, if you have a back wiper on your vehicle, which I do. So I am going to install my decal up in this area right here. So this is what I am going to clean with alcohol. Again, you do not want to have this alcohol run down onto your vehicle. You just want it clean your window. So I'm not gonna like really saturate the paper towel. Just put some on there so that it's a little damp so that I can clean this surface. And my car is pretty dirty because it sits under a tree. And right now we're going through the window. Right now we're going through the seasonal change. Look at all this dirt. So make sure you clean it. I'm going to clean it one more time just to make sure. And then I've got my paper towel, my coffee filter to wipe that up. So now I have my decal and I want to decide about where I want it to go. So I think there's a good spot. And one thing you don't want to do is you don't want to just pull this off your backing. You have a side here that's covered. It's a plastic carrier sheet. That's what your decal is sitting on. And then you're actually going to peel the paperback side off. But what I like to do is just fold down the top of my paper so that I can release just a little bit of the top. And I'm hoping you can see that where I've got the plastic still hanging at the top. Then I'm going to stick that plastic onto my car where I want it. Press that down. So now that's just stuck on the car and this part is just flapping, just that little piece at the top. I'm going to get my squeegee or my credit card. It doesn't matter, room, hotel room key, anything that you can use as a squeegee. I'm gonna go underneath and pull this paper down just a little bit. Use my squeegee, press through all of that. I want to make sure it's stuck, and then I just go ahead and pull down. As I'm pulling down, I'm just making sure that I keep this decal flat. So I'm going to rub the entire decal to make sure everything's adhered. So now I've got that on, but I still have my carrier sheet. Now we want to remove the carrier sheet, and you want to do it at an angle, not straight down. You actually want to pull one corner up of your carrier sheet. Pull it at an angle. And there's your decal. Now, one thing about a decal is that it does take 24 hours to cure. I like to let things cure for 3 or 4 days, maybe even up to a week on stuff like this. So at least make sure that it's not going to rain within 24 hours of you installing your decal. Thank you all so much. And if you're interested in any of these products, please just email me at teaquilts@teaquilts.com. I will eventually get these onto my website, but I thought that I would do this video so that you will know what your options are while you're ordering other things from me. Thank you all so much. Bye-bye.